Biochemical markers in acute coronary syndrome. Important biochemical markers in acute coronary syndrome are troponin, high sensitivity, high specificity for myocardial tissue. CKMB, less tissue specific but useful in diagnosing reinfarction. Myoglobin for rapid diagnosis. But current practice is to use mostly troponin because of high sensitivity and specificity. Advantages of troponin are that they are useful in risk stratification, have a better sensitivity and specificity than CKMB, can detect recent myocardial infarction, and facilitates the selection of treatment modality. Disadvantages of troponin are that the sensitivity is low in the early hours, needs repeat measurements at 8 to 12 hours if negative, and has limited ability to detect late minor reinfarction. Troponins are useful as a single test to efficiently diagnose non-ST elevation myocardial infarction. One should be familiar with the diagnostic cutoffs in the local lab. Delta troponin is the serial elevation of troponin over 1 or 2 hours. This needs 2 serial samples, and delta troponin ranges for the lab technique should be available. Delta troponin is useful for the early rule-in, early rule-out strategy in the emergency department. Non-myocardial infarction causes of troponin elevation: cardiac failure with myonecrosis, cardiac surgery, myocarditis, and renal failure are the important causes of troponin elevation other than myocardial infarction. Now these are classified under myocardial injury and have similar prognostic significance as troponin elevations due to myocardial infarction. Creatine kinase MB fraction or CKMB. Advantages are that the assay is rapid, cost efficient, accurate, and detects early reinfarction. Disadvantages are the lower specificity and low sensitivity during early phase or later after onset of symptoms and for minor myocardial damage. Advantage of CKMB isoforms is for the detection of early myocardial infarction 3 to 6 hours after onset of symptoms. Disadvantages of CKMB isoforms are that the specificity profile is similar to that of CKMB and current assays require special expertise and are used predominantly as a research tool. Advantages of myoglobin are the high sensitivity and utility in early detection 2 hours after the onset of symptoms and hence most useful in ruling out myocardial infarction. Disadvantages of myoglobin are the very low specificity in the setting of skeletal muscle injury or disease, rapid return to normal, and it should not be used in isolation. Patients without biochemical evidence of myocardial necrosis but who have an elevated CRP are at an increased risk of an adverse outcome. Elevated levels of interleukin-6 and serum amyloid A have similar predictive value as CRP. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.